I had all the good intentions. Tapos ganun pa. But I was the one, in fact, who really pushed for the railway system. So I defended the North Rail, the subway system, the new Clark International Airport, the improvement of the airport, the modernization of the other airports, the Mindanao railway system. Ang kulang na lang yung Bicol eh. Yung...
So are you running again in Senate? Kung nasa Senado po kayo ngayon, ano yung mga priority bills na gusto nyo sanang isulong, especially when it comes to the COVID-19 response of the government?
Right now, we see that because it's really complicated. The whole world is in shock. No? Mm-hmm. We cannot also entirely blame our own government because the whole world is also struggling, no? Even the first world nations. No? Kaya lang, I would say that, partly, nakatulong na rin the things that I have done. No, there are some hospitals that have increased their bed capacity, rehabilitate and modernized. Some, like the one in Southern Isabela Medical Center, which I sponsored, PJ Garcia in Nueva Ecija, talagang they have new 8 to 9 story buildings that are now being used, no? DGH, no? But it's still continued. Baguio General, Visoto, Southern Philippines Medical. But still, first day kasi I would have wanted to be there and continue all of the improvement of all these health facilities. No? Southern Philippines Medical Center, Visoto, and BGH, they will now have their own lung center, heart center, and kidney center according to the program, no, that we have in the Universal Healthcare Law para to decongest our own Philippine Heart Center and Lung Center of the Philippines and Kidney Center. So, people in Mindanao, Visayas, Northern Luzon don't have to come to Manila. No, they just have to stay there. Go to SPMC, Visoto, and BGH. So, tapos, there are some issues, no, na yung PhilHealth would use the law, yun yung nakakalungkot. Eh, because I was not there, I cannot answer back. Tulad nung sa OFWs. When they were asking for a raise in premiums, all the OFWs were in uproar and were really furious, no? Na, well, you cannot blame them because they are first faced with uncertainty because of the pandemic. Ito naman si PhilHealth, siguro probably also in need of money, was raising the premiums left and right, no? So, I was not there to defend myself and nakakalungkot because OFWs even also, no, were furious about against me when they found out I'm the author. And I had to remind everybody that when we passed this law, it was a normal, no? Everything was normal. The world was doing well. Economies were doing well. Everybody was earning very well. No? So, kumbaga kayang-kaya, we have to invest. Now, this is an investment. Universal healthcare law, it's an investment for the future that in case anyone gets sick in the family, hindi lang yung OFW, all their families will be taken care of. No? So, they were furious. But had I been in the Senate, I would have been there to answer and also tell PhilHealth that, you know, as the principal sponsor, it was normal times. We are in an abnormal time. It is a pandemic. We have to adapt to the situation. And I would have told them not to raise any premiums, no, at this time. So, nangyari, they raised it either. They used the law to justify. So, yun yung manakakalungkot. Parang, syempre, that I have to be honest, sabi ko, I felt bad because or yung mga OFWs were enraged and blaming me. Syempre, I was so... I would say kind of depressed, sad kasi I was thinking about themselves also and their families, no? Just imagine, Rina, if an OFW, for example, retires, brings home 3-4 million pesos as a savings,
yes,
no, or even 5 million pesos, but for example he gets sick or any member of the family gets sick,
ubos agad yon,
no? Ubos ka agad yon,
yes,
diba? So I'm hoping that could be prevented. So that's because with the universal healthcare law, probably they didn't know that yung packages have also leveled up. Just to give an example, for example, a breast cancer, if somebody has breast cancer, an OFW or an employee or any member of the family, they can get 200,000 pesos already. because of the universal healthcare law, di ba? As assistance. If you get, I think if you get operated on the heart, kung halimbawa bypass or angioplasty or basta bypass, I think it's 500,000 pesos no, under the universal healthcare law. Kung kidney transplant or any other major operation, as high as 600,000. Mm-hmm. Now, we talk about COVID. Pag na-COVID ka, I think you can get as high as 15,000 to 30,000 pesos. If it progresses to pneumonia, I think about 300,000 and intubated as high as 800,000 because of universal healthcare law. So, ayun. Probably, a lot of people do not know that the packages that they can get have also leveled up. Pero alam mo naman dito sa social media, this day and age, pag nakita lang, oh, dahil yung premiums were increased, galit na kagad, no? Without researching.
Even understanding it.
Yes. So yun, syempre, sometimes I get frustrated. I have to admit, I feel sad that these things are happen, no? Parang I had all the good intentions, no? By passing this law. Tapos ganun pa. But probably it's because I'm not in the Senate anymore. I'm not there to answer and to tell PhilHealth, no, as the sponsor. No, yes. That is not what I was after. I passed this law during normal times and it is abnormal. We have to adapt. So, yun lang. Parang I would say that I'm not fear but more of frustration right now that I am feeling that we have this pandemic and I could have done more. I know that I could have done more, helped more if I was there.
So, are you running again in Senate? Sir JV.
Well, given the chance, I would want really to compete. No? I don't want to. I was able to pass UHC. I was able to pass DH, Department of Human Settlements. But anyway, I don't want it half baked, diba? As we talked about, it's a continuing. It's a work in progress.
Mm-hmm.
And I would want it to be realized and implemented properly. So, if given the chance, I am hoping that I could oversee implementation of these things and a lot more. No? Another advocacy of mine is infrastructure development. It's not being mentioned. No, I used to be vice chair of the Committee on Finance. I used to defend the budget of TOTR under the Duterte administration. So most of the build projects, no, the railway system. Because I mentioned earlier, I was fascinated by railways. I was the one, in fact, who really pushed for the railway system early on. No, I had a meeting with Secretary Tugade before they assumed, no? Bago sila nag-assume June 30, I asked for a meeting. And I brought him the idea. I asked him to really push for the railway system because that can be the backbone of the economy. So I defended the North Rail, the subway system, the new Clark International Airport, the improvement of the airport, the modernization of the other airports, the Mindanao railway system. Ang kulang na lang yung Bicol eh, yung Bicol line. No, sayang, kulang. I would have sayang if I had been there, I would have pushed for it also, no? So
okay.
There's still a lot of things that I know I could do.
Mm-hmm.
But the circumstances lang is very complicated because my brother again wants to run.
Mm-hmm.
Again for the Senate.
Mm-hmm.
He has his reasons. I do not want to dwell on that. No? I have my reasons, but it will be 2019 all over again.
Yep.
If it pushes through. So I'm weighing my options at this time.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I really want to be back there to continue what to pick up where I left off. But chances of winning will really be very slim if my brother and I run together again.
Mm-mm,
no?
Mm-mm.
So, I'm hoping for a miracle. It's fast approaching. October deadline is fast approaching.
Yes, the filing of COs.
I think both of us realize that if we both run again,
it will make the people torn. Yeah.
So, mm-hmm. I'm just hoping that, at the time, I was the incumbent. And nakiusap ako, I remember. Because my dad also, sumamay loob ko, I felt bad that he gave his blessing for him to run at that time. And he just got out of krame at that time, di ba? So, I told myself, sana pinatapos na lang ako. That was my exact, those were my exact words. Because yes. I was an incumbent. I guess I was doing well. I am performing decently. Ayoko nang sabihin magaling ako, but performing decently as a senator back then. And lastly, my public service record is untainted, no?
Yes.
I have a clean public service record. Mm-hmm. I have a good performance. So, yun. Sana pinatapos nila ako. Were my exact words back then.
Mm-hmm. Any message for the youth right now, for the viewers, no, who wanted to be like you in the future, po, Sir JV?
Well, to all those who want to serve government or have the station, siguro just remember what yung Mahatma Gandhi said, no? Be the change you want the world to be. No, no. Wag tayong ano, it has to come from us, eh, no? Wag yung ano lang tayo, wag yung lagi lang tayo nasa social media ranting, complaining, whining. Mm-hmm. No? We have to change, has to start from us. Do something productive, di ba? So in this day and age of social media, we're so used to that, no? A lot of whining and complaining. So
yes.
let us be more productive, di ba? And the very simple formula that I follow in my 18 years of being a public servant is simple. No? Putting the interest of the country above self, because everything will just follow. No? Hindi ako nagpapakabayani, pero yun lang eh. Very simple. No? Kasi I know that God will provide my needs, my personal needs. I'm also a person. I have to be admit. I also have my own personal needs, no, for my family, myself.
Yes, yes.
But, you know, you just have to put the interest of country, and then probably family, yourself, and God, and then yourself, and everything else we just follow.
Okay.
Yun lang. Very simple ako mag-ano eh. Based on my experience, I think that those very simple formula works for me. And yun nga, yung quote ko, yung on Gandhi, if you really want, we have to become siguro my advice to the youth, if you want change, it has to start from us, and given the opportunity, try to make a difference. No? Sometimes opportunity only knocks once. Make the most out of it.
Grab it.
No? Grab the opportunity and make the most out of it. No? Mm-hmm. Make a difference. Kumbaga, I think I did, I would say, as a mayor, as a senator, in my very short, in my one term, not everybody can pass two landmark laws in that so short a time. And, you know, Rina, I'm not the brightest of all, no? I'm not mas matalino definitely in the Senate than me, but I'm just practical, no? I think simple. I want things that are attainable. And I know that, you know, I probably just know what people really need, no? Probably because of my exposure in the real world, no? At a young age, even up to now.
Ayan, before we end the show, Sir JV, no, so our viewers can get to know more about you, I'm going to ask you a question lang po, and you can only answer with one word lang po. Or I'm going to give you choices, tapos pumili lang po kayo ng isa doon. Is that okay with you, sir? Okay, yes. Sige po. Let's start this. What's your stress reliever?
My dogs and biking, riding. I love dogs. Okay. I love my dogs.
Okay. Favorite food?
Oh my God. My favorite food. That's a tough one.
Ang dami.
Yeah. Filipino food, of course. Native. Okay. Laing in particular. I love laing.
Okay. Laing. Biko pa nga pang Bicol na Bicolano. Ganyan.
Yes, I love
favorite
it.
Favorite movie? Sir Jamie.
Favorite mid movie. My God. Ano ba? Favorite movie. Ano kaya? Hindi kasama yung Tagalog. Ano, no? Hindi kasama yung Crash Landing on You, no? Kasi di mo movie.
Pwede yun.
Just kidding.
I'm also a fan. Don't worry.
Ah, I like yung itong ano eh, yung recently yung sa Netflix, The Last Kingdom. I like The Last Kingdom.
Yes, yeah. Okay.
Gladiator, okay. I like those.
Kind of movies.
I don't know why. Yeah, I don't know why. Yeah.
Okay.
Last Kingdom, I really like. And you learn in history and then yung Gladiator, you know.
Okay.
Being favorite a warrior. Place. Favorite place? Probably Ifugao, Sagada.
Ilocos.
No, that's in no? Region. Diba? No, that's in Cagayan, Mountain Province.
Yes,
Sagada in Ifugao, because that's where you can find the eighth wonder of the world, which is the Benawi Rice Terrace. And so beautiful, and really, I really love it. No, so it's really serene, so peaceful. It's like Baguio 40, 50 years ago. No. Without the commercial aspect. So Sagada in Ifugao, that region.
What's your pet peeve?
What kaya?
Ano ba yung ayaw nyo?
Abusive people.
Okay. Okay. This time around, one last na ha. Let's complete the sentence. I'll say a phrase lang po and you need to complete the sentence. Okay? Pangarap kong blank.
What? Pangarap kong blank?
Yes, blank.
Pangarap kong mayangat ang buhay ng bawat Pilipino. Very political. Sounds political, but I think it's because of my two landmark laws that, you know, when they are successfully implemented, it's going towards that, improving the quality of lives of our people. I think, I'm so confused. It may sound political, para siyang motherhood, but I think with the things that I have done, the landmark laws that I have done, that is my dream. For it to be implemented one day, and for the people not to, at least, you know, they can feel it that the government is there when they need it, when they need it.
One last, ito na lang. Very popular ito eh. Winarak mo ang.
Winarak mo ang career, ang ano ko, panandalian ng career ko.
Oh no!
Sayang.
Oh no!
Bato-bato sa langit. Bato-bato sa langit. Sayang eh, no? Kasi sayang, yes, you know. Have to be honest, I'm nakaka-frustrate because I did lose because of my own doing. Di ba? Sayang talaga.
Yes. Thank you so much for a fun talk this evening po, Sir JV Ejercito.
Yeah, thank you.
Saw a different side of you today. Any takeaway from viewers po? May mga mensahe po ba kayo sa ating mga viewers?
Well, yun lang. I'm hoping just take care of yourselves, guys. I hope that we will get through this, no, itong pandemic together. Mm-hmm. And again, to the youth, I hope that you remember, to the millennials and Gen Z, Sen JV mentioned earlier, give it the opportunity, make a difference. No, we only have, there are only three kinds of people in this world. Those who watch for things to happen, those who wait for things to happen, and those who make things happen. So, make things happen and make a difference.
That's a good advice po, for everyone listening and watching right now. Social media pages that you wanted to promote po.
Yes, I have my Facebook fan page, so you can follow me, yung mga adventures ko, yung mga discoveries, nice places. Para we can help the economy, no? Our tourism, Facebook page, JV Ejercito, my fan page, and then yung mga food discoveries also. And I have a YouTube channel. It's quite new, no? Konti pa lang yung ano eh. I prepared some nice places to go to and good food, no? Food discoveries. So, JV Ejercito present, JV presents the good ones, no? JV presents the good ones. So, I hope you can follow. At least yung mga food discoveries and nice places that you can go to when the situation's better, at least ano, I can share with you the nice places.
So you need to subscribe po dun sa YouTube channel ni Sir JV.
Yes, please like, share, and subscribe.
Yan. Maraming salamat po sa ating discussion this evening, Sir JV Ejercito, and more power to you, sir. God bless po. And that's it for The Public Servant. We will see you again next time, only here on Com Network. Please don't forget to like, follow, and share our official Facebook and YouTube channel. It's Com Network. Again, I'm Rina Valimor, Camera. Good night.